Many in the Somali community feel a lot of trauma from being, because of the war, because of what they went through moving as refugees across the world, not just in Canada, but all over the world. So what's happened is that they've internalized a lot of pain. And when anything that triggers that pain, the community is uncomfortable talking about it. Many topics that I interview people about, whether it's mental health, whether it's rape, whether it's like cancer, they feel very uncomfortable because these topics are taboo topics that people don't talk about in our society. And many times when someone gets an illness, it's seen as like, it's more from a religious perspective also. They see it as, oh, this is something God has brought, so why should I complain about it? But I think as a new generation, for myself who grew up in this society, we see the difference in the two cultures where we look at it as, okay, it's good to talk about your shared experience. It's good to share your knowledge and what you're going through so that you don't internalize pain. But this lack of sharing comes from the pain the community has experienced from just being basically refugees all over the world and not having families to connect to. Many times, even if they are going through an illness, they don't have the support system because their brother might be in Australia who got a refugee status there, or they might be in Europe. So because we're such scattered people and because there's lack of like emotional pain connection, that's where the uncomfortableness comes from discussing these type of issues in our community.